Final Fantasy XII for the PlayStation 2. This is a game I personally really hate. I think I would go to that level. Not even like just not like, but really hate. And it kind of makes sense looking back on it, because it really is a love it or hate it type of game. A lot of professional reviewers, a lot of gamers really thought this as a masterpiece, and then people like me on this camp really just thought this was not a game worth your time, not even worth the rental even. And so there is this two camps over here. Majority of our people are going to be in the either love it camp or the hate it camp, with very few people in the middle camp kind of qualifying. I like this. I like this part. I like this part. So now that I've made my personal view on the game known, I do want to explore kind of, because I do understand why some people may think it's a masterpiece. And here's why. And two simple things, really. Production value and innovation. Production value-wise, its graphics are really stunning and extremely detailed, especially considering how many, just how various the locales are and how massive the game's scope is. The environments in the featured in the game are just presented in a marvelous manner, and the script is written elegantly, and the voice work matches that elegance. So, production value is really great. Its presentation, its graphics, its voice work, everything. It just screams that, it's evident that the developer spent a lot of money and effort into this title. Another thing that professional reviewers, of course, critics love is innovation, and Final Fantasy XII is very innovative, bringing the mechanics of an online MMO into an offline single-player only RPG experience. And at the same time it does that, Final Fantasy XII isn't just a simple hack and slash that many real-time RPGs resort to when they take out such outdated mechanics as turn-based battle system and random encounters. Instead of that, they created this new system called the Gambit, in which you can prioritize your character's actions and take control of your character's action directly when you have to. That simple mechanic alone sets Final Fantasy XII apart from pretty much every RPG made in the past, and in a sense, even now. Because professional game critics and a lot of gamers love innovation, love production value, it really is a masterpiece. And that's gonna make you wonder, so why the hate? Well, there's a lot of reasons why I really had a falling out with this game. It started out great for me, but geez. What the professional critics miscalculated is that the production value and innovation cannot by themselves produce a compelling experience. Even though Final Fantasy XII should probably be considered as a masterpiece for what it accomplishes, everything it does in a very boring and a dull manner. Also, the so-called innovative features unexploited are actually very flawed and produces a disconnect for a lot of gamers, including me. And finally, the core design choices in this game are simply aggravating to a lot of gamers. First off, as elegant and as beautiful as the game's script is, the game's overall story is very, very shallow, with close to no character development at all. Not only are the main protagonists of this story not relatable, they have no interesting persona, no deep past, no complex motives. In a genre that puts its focus so heavily on the storytelling and in the presentations of the characters, Final Fantasy XII simply falls flat. The cutscenes are extremely gorgeous when it's shown, but they usually don't last for more than 10 seconds, and they're very rare in the game. The story is rarely progressed, and the only really interesting parts are in the very beginning introduction, the very middle, kind of like 40 hours into the game, and the finale. This kind of storytelling fits the grandiose style, and I guess it's because the game wants to be known as a masterpiece, but ultimately, to us gamers who only really care about an entertaining story and characters to fall in love with or hate with passion, Final Fantasy XII just didn't do its job right at all. Another thing is in the level design. Bedazzling to the eyes, but boring to play. For an RPG, these levels are simply too big and too long. The beaches are great to look at, but walking past three huge areas of the beach is just overdoing it. And so is making a tower be 100 stories tall and requiring gamers to walk up all the way to the top for the most part. High production value is great, but not really when it sacrifices enjoyment. As for the new innovative features, they're actually quite troublesome. The Gambit system is unique, But when the perfect combinations of priorities are eventually figured out, even the old turn-based games where you just had to repeatedly press X to win become more exciting. Because by then, all Final Fantasy XII requires is that you move your characters around with the analog stick, and everything else is done for you automatically. So, I mean, of course, it's going to take some time to figure out the perfect gambit, mind you. And that in itself is pretty interesting. But once you figure out, you know, encounter the enemy when you see, you have this gambit system, and you kind of created an algorithm for the characters to follow, in most cases, it's going to be fine to just walk around and your character does everything according to script, and you're not going to really need to change it until the boss battle hits. And in that case, it just becomes a boring game. You're not even pressing X anymore. You're just holding the analog stick up so that the character moves forward. And the character does all the random battles for you and wins. So that really made me into a lazy gamer, more like a watcher of my pre-programmed moves. You know, and when I encountered a boss that made me change my gambit priorities a bit, or actually use special moves, I actually got a bit irritated, because that's how lazy the game made me become. So instead of being excited that, oh, now I get to change my gambits and strategize, I became annoyed. It's like, oh man, I have to change my gambits that I perfected, kind of like change it to start healing when the HP is 40%, change that a little bit, or stuff like that, especially when I come across like these special summoning monsters. Espers, that's right. When I come across Espers, some of them I really had to change the gambit because they really required a different playstyle. But changing gambits by itself, you know, that's a good strategy. It just got cumbersome a bit with all the random encounters that happens. The other gameplay flaws are actually more serious than the gambit system, which is, I guess, the gambit system being problematic was much more of a problem with me than it is with the game itself, just because it made me into a lazy gamer and made me irritated when I actually had to change the gambits. The other things are actually more regarding to the flaw of the game, such as the combat. The magic spells are broken. Not only are they extremely expensive to obtain, but every magic trick, especially the good ones, have a very high failure rate. Usually in RPGs, a magic attack never fails, unless it's a status-affecting magic. So, you know, I've never played a Final Fantasy game where I used a magic attack and the result was miss. You know, that was usually for physical attacks. But in Final Fantasy XII, your magic attacks usually miss. And they have all magical spells have a high rate of failures, even status-affecting ones. Not just the status-affected ones, but every magic. Furthermore, the summons, called Espers in Final Fantasy XII, are pretty much worthless, because summoning a powerful Esper will eliminate any ally characters you have with you, and it will only last for 2 minutes, and they're not even that powerful. During those 2 minutes, the summoned Esper will attack the enemies automatically, depending on the circumstances. This sounds good, but the problem is that the circumstances in question are not the circumstances of the battlefield, but of your character, or your Esper. So, for example, there's this Esper that you summon, and in order for it to do a special move, you have to be in a zombified state. So you have to be in like a zombie status for it to actually trigger a move, which doesn't make sense. Or how about your Esper having to have only 10% of its health to heal your character? I mean, look, that's really innovative and all, but why couldn't this have been more traditional, where it actually makes sense, where the gameplay actually feels more fluid? If I have to make my Esper be 10% health, or myself to be 10% health for my Esper to heal me, there is no strategizing in that. It's just so random and luck-driven. That's the problem with a lot of the gameplay mechanics of Final Fantasy XII, is that it's so reliant on luck and random chance. There's so many other troublesome mechanics as well. The level-up system in Final Fantasy XII is called a license board, in which you unlock different abilities and weapon access for your characters as you gain experience, which are called license points. This sounds good on paper, but in execution, it does not allow for any variability among your characters. Pretty soon, and rather quickly too, Baldir has the same abilities as Fran, Van, and everyone else. Thus, picking which character to use does not involve really any kind of strategy at all, and this lack of variety makes the game even more uninteresting. So, I mean, you can kind of look back and see, oh, but it's kind of similar to the Spear Grid system of Final Fantasy X, in which case you would be partly right. But even in the Spear Grid system, in which any character could have any powers, you still had characters that had base stats that really affected their whatever their powers may be. Like, Yuna could learn a warrior's ability, like Power Break or Armor Break, yes. But at the same time, her magic starts out so strongly that it will take a lot of time in order for her to actually be more of a physical fighter than a magic user. In Final Fantasy XII, that base stat is so similar for all the other characters that once, I don't know, it makes the characters not have a special personality, even in gameplay. That's the problem. They don't have special personality in the storytelling-wise. They don't have special personality gameplay-wise, either. Then there are the side quests, or should I even call them side quests? The design choices behind these quests, I feel, were poor. Making a gamer walk up to a posted board to accept a quest, and then requiring that person to talk to the person who petitioned that quest, just so you're permitted to go to the area, and then go to the area and do the quest, and then come walk all the way back to the petitioner to receive your reward. You have to do this for every side quest. All this is extremely cumbersome and repetitive, and it's just unneeded. And these side quests, the reason I don't really want to call them side quests because they're just additional encounters with rare monsters. They're not diversions, they're not mini games. They're just there to do more grinding, more battling, as if you don't already do enough battling to grind in the main game. But then again, grinding isn't really important in this game other than to get license points, because the loot you get in Final Fantasy XII are there only to be sold and sold at rip-off prices. So, I mean, those are all the reasons, really, why I do not like Final Fantasy XII at all. If it had a really engaging and interesting storyline to boot, I wouldn't have minded so many gameplay flaws. But in the end, after the credit sequence rolled and I spent 86 hours in this game, I sat down. You know, the credits was rolling. I was like, that's it? I just wasted 80 hours of my life for this? You know, it was a very, very disappointing moment, and that's an understatement.